Hello students, now in this discussion we shall look at one more, the second one, single payment present worth amount. Single payment present worth amount. So as we have discussed earlier, first was FD, like what is the future amount I am getting based on the future amount I am going to get if I invest something P today for some period N and interest rate I. Now here the objective is to find the present worth amount P of a single future sum F, single amount, it is means one time. Again this present worth also P one time, single time, which will be received after N period at an interest rate of I compounded at the end of every interest period. Okay, so the cash flow diagram is like this. I invest something and P today, and F I will get after N period, means N number of years, and I is the interest rate. So the formula is the same formula. Now here we have shown F is equal to P in bracket 1 plus I raised to N. Here earlier I calculated F, now I am calculating P, present worth. P is equal to F divided by 1 plus I raised to N, and where P bar F comma I comma N is termed as a single payment present worth factor. Now to better understand this, we will take you can take the same problem also, like I am investing, I want 293 rupees at the end of 5 years. Suppose I want 293 rupees at the end of 5 years, and the rate of interest is 8%. So how much I have to invest today? So how much I have to invest today so that I can get 293 rupees at the end of 5 years at an interest rate of 8%? So again, using the formula F is equal to P 1 plus I raised to N. So I know the future amount 293. So I am only going to calculate P. So you will find the value of P as 200. You will find the value of P as 200. Okay, so if I invest 200 now, then I will get 293 rupees at the end of 5 years at the rate of 8%. This is known as single payment present worth amount. So the present worth is 200 rupees. Another problem, if you want, you can take more realistic this problem. Mr. X wishes to have a future sum of 50 lakhs for his daughter's tuition fee at the end of 10 years. So his daughter is young. Mr. X has a daughter, he is young, and after 10 years he is going to study some professional course. So it requires 50 lakh rupees. What is the single amount he should deposit now so that he gets the desired amount after 10 years? So he wants to make some investment now, one single investment, so that he can get 50 lakh rupees at the end of 10 years. Considering the bank gives an interest rate of 12% compounded annually. Okay. The same thing, you have to use the same formula. P is equal to F is equal to P into bracket 1 plus I raised to N. Okay, here we are only going to find out P. Here we are going to find out P. So now if you substitute the values, you will find out P is equal to F divided by 1 plus I raised to N. Here the future amount what we require is 50 lakhs. I is 12%, that is 0.12. And N is equal to 10 years, after 10 years. So it is 50 lakhs divided by 1 plus 0.12 raised to 10. So the amount becomes 6,43,000. So if Mr. X invests 6,43,000 rupees today in the bank, which gives him interest rate of 12% compounded annually, then after 10 years he will get the amount of 50 lakh rupees. Okay. So this is the simple example. What we have seen, okay, single payment present worth amount. So what is the present worth today's worth? What is the amount? That is what we are seeing today in this problem. Okay, thank you.